A long time ago, before the dinosaurs and stuff, the Earth was ruled by an even deadlier species. Today, using science, genetics, and Argentinian craftsmanship, these monsters have been brought back to life. Welcome to Total Wipeout. Let's just hope they don't escape and eat the contestants. Tonight, 20 Brits, including a postman, a maths teacher, and an opera singer, will attempt to tackle these world-renowned plastic predators. Let the games begin. Hello and welcome to Total Wipeout, which tonight is filmed in front of a live studio audience. All the usual frills and spills, but this time it's all in front of a live studio audience.
Oh, this is great.
Hey, what do you call a coach horse that can play bass guitar? Paul McCartney.
Okay, let's see what the competitors are up against today.
The Qualifier, tough with a capital T. Double Cross, tough with a capital T, underlined. Terrogoround, tough with a capital T, underlined and involved. And the Wipeout Zone, tough, all in capitals, double underlined, in bold, and with like a few exclamation marks at the end.
Tonight's show promises to be a real roller coaster. And, not yet. Tonight's show. Right, forget it. We're not doing the whole audience thing now. Let's join Amanda at the top of the course with today's first contestant. Paul McCartney. It's genius.
Special delivery for the qualifier. As I'm joined now by my next contestant, this is Michael from St. Helens and he's a postman. Michael, how are you doing?
I am aiming to become a legend on the mail delivering circuit of St. Helens. And I'm not just talking St. Helens, Amanda. This could propel me to the big time. I'm talking the outskirts as well. I'm talking Haydock, Billinge, Rainford, Thatto Heath.
So, 40-year-old, slightly terrifying postie Michael is the first to tackle today's qualifier. He talks the talk, but will he deliver on the course? Well, he's quickly across the pontoons, which means he's about to come to the first stop on his route. A brand new addition to the Total Wipeout course, the Wall Street Smash. It's three obstacles in one. Contestants must keep one eye on the sweeping up, the other eye on keeping their balance, and then the other eye on the giant pieces of wall that swing out and smash you in the face. Here we go. Oh, special delivery.
Oh, watch your head, Michael.
That Wall Street Smash doesn't like unexpected mail, so unexpected mail, spelled differently, you see, Michael, is stamped and sent straight to his destination, Muddy Waterville. Painful lesson to learn. He won't be doing that again in a hurry. Here he goes. Watch out for the... Oh, be careful of the... And the... Then there's the... Yeah. Oh, no. No, he's in. This is tricky, isn't it? Next, it punches. It punches, it squirts paint, and it punches some more. Here we go. Well, oh, he's ducked the paint, but not the fists. Avoided damaging his package, but it's not really an express delivery so far. Now, for the part of his route that he's dreading. Four big red spheres that don't know the meaning of the words do not bet. The big red balls. Oh, yeah, that works.
Oh, buddy!
Ball one. And he's in. Oh. Second class fall.
That was rubbish!
Maybe he'll have a bit more luck on the final obstacle. It's the shapeshifter. Up the ladder, down the slide, and which window should we go through today? The square window. The triangle window. Or the round window. Yeah, that's right. Probably none of them. So the postman has nearly reached his final destination. All he has to do now is post himself through one of the holes. Should be easy for Michael. Here we go.
Oh, no, no.
A postman missing the hole.
Starting to wonder if anyone in St Helens has ever received any post at all. Second class Michael posts a time of 2 minutes 36. Will that send him through to the next round?
I won't go as far as saying it was a special delivery by any standards. Certainly first class. Possibly going on to second class.
Next to take on the qualifier is 22-year-old Amita, who describes herself simply as awesome. Awesome, awesome.
What kind of things do you do in your life to make you feel that you're awesome?
Multiple black belts in karate, mango juggling, professional air guitar. I can do the waltz, I think. Yes, I can do the waltz. I can shoot a bow and arrow. I can ride a motorbike. I can rally drive a car. I can play snap. I'm pretty good at snap.
Balance
on a ball quite well. Jumping, I've got a good long jump. I can play Scrabble. I can play football. I can ski. Balance on a ball quite well. I can scuba dive, I can snowboard, I can skydive.
Amita, are you telling porcupines?
No, I forgot to tell a pole dance.
Okay, that's enough of that. Let's see how useful her long and honest list of genuine skills will be on the qualifier. Is that on purpose? The Wall Street Smash, a true test of Amita's awesomeness. So here she goes. She's on, this is it. Yeah, wall smash to the head, sweeper hit to the body. It's kind of more average than awesome. That's just what happens. Awesome, yeah. Double awesome. But Amita is still standing strong, give her that.
Ooh!
I think the sucker punch must be losing its touch. Oh, no, there it is. Yeah, there's the touch. Not really awesome. Adequate. Yes, adequate. Amita is currently unemployed, but with all the awesome skills she's learned today, I'm sure a new career is just around the corner. No, there's a crash test dummy, maybe. But awesome Amita finishes the qualifier in 3 minutes 23 and can now add mechanical rubber assault courses to her long list of made-up skills. Meet happily married Philip and Eve.
Aw, that's sweet.
Philip, you may be my husband and an engineer, but this Bruce English is going to summon this cross and punish you for drinking all that beer!
I didn't understand most of that, but it sounded sort of cross. So it's 30-year-old Eve that kicks off this matrimonial face-off. A lot at stake here. Here we go. An early slip. She's gone. She's back. Now, Eve's small stature is an advantage here. Easily ducking under those smashed doors. Yes. Oh, no. You can't duck the sweeper, Eve. Oh, hang on. Oh, and that's a big hit to the little Brazilian. I bet she can hear wedding bells right now.
Eve, you may be my wife. I'm going to rip you to shreds.
Oh, and they say romance is dead. Philip on the sucker punch. He is not only representing England, he's representing husbands and headband wearers everywhere. Oh, right in the nuptials.
Oh, Philip!
Big red balls for Eve. Good chance to show hubby how it's done. Well, there's the demotivator, and she's in. It works. Will Philip make the same mistake? No, he charges. One, two, three. No, not this time.
What was that hop, skip and a jump for Looney? Oh, darling, there ain't no pleasing
you. Their times are very close, so the war of the wedded will be settled on the shapeshifter. Bragging rights and a year of washing up at stake here. Eve goes for it. She's in. She's out. Which means it's all down to this one last slide. Never has so much rested on what can only be described as, well, playground equipment. Philip's lost his headband, but will he keep his pride? Nope. There it goes, into the water. And this was virtually identical to Eve's effort. It's like they were meant to be together. It's beautiful, that.
Yeah.
Spiritually linked. Mrs. Eve finishes in 2 minutes 36, but it's Mr. Philip who wears the trousers and a smug grin, finishing in just under 2 minutes.
Woo!
This is air traffic controller Zoe Spain.
Is it a bird? Is it a plane? No, it's Zoe Spain.
Yeah, she's not from Spain, she's from Egham.
What a cool, big, important job you have to clear the skies of danger and to guide jumbo jets into land.
Actually, it's quite a small little airport in Surrey, looking at the Surrey Downs, called Fair Oaks. It's not that big.
Zoe Spain, who's not from Spain, takes off down the runway and... Oh, eject! Eject! Too late.
That was a bit of a crash landing.
Let's fly, let's fly. Now she's up against two giant propellers. Her aviation skills might just come in handy here. One, good start. No, oh dear, no. She's in. In case of an emergency, Zoe is pointing out the nearest exit to your right, down the steps, and into the muddy water. Now it's the sucker punch. Will it put the pain into Zoe Spain? Oh, well, so far, so good. Zoe taking every punch firmly on the chin.
Good girl!
Very brave or very stupid. It's brave because she's made it. Zoe's face must be black and blue and yellow and a bit orange, is that? Mother looks at it? Yeah. Not sure she can take much more of this punishment. So, she's at the top of the slide. She slides down. Oh!
This is... No, and now she's... Oh, no! Oh, dear.
Hold on, hang tight!
I'm leaving on a jet plane. Yeah, but, you know, no pain, no gain. And with all that pain, Zoe has gained a good time and now needs to gain some medical attention.
Next is 25-year-old petrolhead Nathan from Kent.
So, Nathan, you clearly feel the need for speed. But how speedy are you going to be out there on those big red balls?
That's going to be faster than that. That's faster than that.
Everyone turn a total wipe out, but this is going to be a total wipe wash.
That's a bad thing, isn't it? Okay. Right. Well, softly, softly. Catchy. Well, nothing. But he's up quickly and puts his foot on the pedal, accelerating. Thankfully, there's no speed cameras here. Good manoeuvres from Nathan. Oh, he's cleared. No. One slip and he was in. Who's gonna drive you home? It looked like he'd regained control, but he swerves into the hard shoulder. Now he's got a wet shoulder as well. Onto the sucker punch. Oh, yeah, that was harsh. Oh, that was a proper whack. Forcing Nathan into a quick muddy pit stop. Drive slow, homie. Oh, say quick. Right, he's got the green light for the big red balls. Go, 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 go. Yes, no, yes, no. False start.
Not so Formula One now.
But Nitro Nathan lives up to his speedy boast, finishing in 2 minutes 16. Not bad. Oh. So, six runners in, and it's Mr. Philip that's taken the early lead with Nitro Nathan hot on his heels. Second class Michael shares third with Mrs. Eve, and Zoe, not from Spain, is in fifth. Awesome Amita is not living up to her name, sat in sixth.
For years, I've been pitching Total Wipeout the movie, but due to lack of funding, lack of interest, me not having got around to writing the script, Angelina Jolie not returning any of my calls, and the whole restraining order thing, it's remained a mere pipe dream until today. For now, I have the budget. Well, ish. And a leading actor, 28-year-old Jonathan from Cumbria. So, here goes. I've always wanted to do this. Action! Oh, doesn't work. Action! No, really, it's not working. That stings! It's broken.
In a land far, far away, well, a 14-hour flight, and then a queue at customs. He was an actor from Cumbria.
Feel the rhythm! Feel the rhyme! Get on up! It's Total Wipeout time!
She was a TV presenter who was watching his every move and laughing. One man must face his fears, defy all the odds, achieve the impossible, and other really dramatic things.
Oh, man, it was useless.
One dream, one chance, one
embarrassing slip on the slide.
If you only see one Argentinian obstacle course-based movie this year, make sure it's this one.
At a supermarket near you. Because it wasn't good enough to get on the big screen.
Well, it needs a bit of work, but Lights, Camera, Jonathan finishes in just under 3 minutes. Next to run and hoping for the luck of the Irish, because he's Irish, is 26-year-old Kevin, who lives in London.
Listen, are you a fighting fit Irishman, Kevin? Is that what you are? Have you got the Celtic spirit in you?
Not really. I'm trying to do a little bit of preparation for this. Didn't go all that well. Went for a jog about 3 weeks ago and did a few push-ups and nearly passed out after it. So other than that, there hasn't been a lot of preparation.
Kevin to the Wall Street Smash. Here we go. Oh, ducks, and again the smash door. Don't scare Kevin. Woo! It's a lot harder to duck 22 mechanical fists, though, and that's what he faces next. See, didn't duck. But he's still on. He's nearly across the sucker punch as well. This is amazing. Oh! This is an impressive run. He's actually good at this stuff. Here we go. Oh, until that happened. The luck of the Irish ran out on the second ball exactly then. It's all gone. Used up. Finished. But he still manages to jig his way into the top spot. Quite good Kev. I'll call him Quite Good Kev, in fact.
That's the most fun I've had with my clothes on in ages. That's unbelievable.
This is 38-year-old master's student Georgia. She has a problem with cats.
You've been getting some unwanted attention, Georgia, from some cats at home. What's that all about?
Oh my God, I have loads of cats. They just come, perch on the back of my fence and look in at me. There's one that wears a denim jacket. Can you imagine a black cat in a denim jacket?
Are you serious?
I'm dead serious.
Okay, right. Well, can't afford to pussyfoot around on the Wall Street Smash. Now, you see, because that's what happens when you do.
Ooh, wonder how she's feline now.
Hey, she beat me to that. I get it. Well, there's no time to pause for thought as Georgia approaches the big red balls. It's mine! Yeah, over we go. That was going to shock her. Oh, dear.
Yep, I think she's used up another one of them 9 lives.
Stop it! Georgia finishes the course in 5 minutes and 14. That puts her in a less than perfect last place. Mine.
Time now for the Total Wipeout Lonely Heart segment. You know, like I do every week, about this time. Today's letter comes from a Mr. W.S. Smash from Buenos Aires. And it reads, Dear Richard, I am unlucky in love. When anyone gets close to me, I end up pushing them away or hurting them. I like to surprise people, sweep them off their feet, but when I open up, all they want to do is run away. Yours, Lonely Lee, the Wall Street Smash. Well, you're in luck.
It's Total Wipeout Dating. But which lucky girl is going to win a date with our mechanical macho man tonight? Will it be contestant number one? She's a 5-foot-tall student who likes shopping and extreme sports, but is terrified of pigeons. Meet fun-sized Tash from Swindon. Will she fall in love? No, just in the water. You saw that coming. I know, so did I. Wall Street Smash has given her the brush off. That's not a great first impression. Contestant number two is a head chef and cage fighter, obviously, which makes her one tough cookie. Meet Kim from Liverpool. So will a cage fighting chef hit it off with the Wall Street Smash?
No, it was just Kim that was hit off.
they say, love hurts. And that did. Can the last contestant win the heart of the 10-foot foam bachelor? She's a dental practice manager that says she's mad as a box of frogs. Number three is always the wacky one. Meet Debbie from Newport. Will she fall head over heels? Well, I'd say, yeah. Yeah, pretty obviously. But on the walls being all bashful. I think true love has been found. Debbie is dizzy in love. Although maybe somebody should check that's not concussion. Could this be a love that lasts forever? Oh no, she's up and doing a runner. Looks like the Wall Street Smash is going home alone tonight.
Lonely, I'm Mr. Lonely, I have nobody.
So let's see how their efforts have affected the current leaderboard. Quite Good Kev has now jigged into the top spot. Fun Size Tash jumps into sixth, and Tough Cookie Kim is only seconds behind in seventh. In ninth, it's Lights, Camera, Jonathan, whilst at the foot of the table is Box of Frogs, Debbie, and Cats Love Georgia in 11th and 12th.
Time for a clash of culture. Now, I'm a big fan of rock music, like Foo Fighters, Led Zepp, AC/DC, but I'm also a big fan of opera music, like that World Cup one that Pavarotti did. Just one cornetto. Well, next, it's a rocker versus an operaist. I'm going to really enjoy this. In fact, I'm going to put my glasses on to enjoy it and then pour myself a crystal glass of vintage champagne.
Doing it for the opera people, it's 40-year-old Jason.
Truly no other they can compare.
And in the rock corner, it's 53-year-old Gene.
Rock and roll fantasy!
I shall win.
Rock and roll fantasy!
Of that have no doubt.
Rock and roll fantasy!
Yeah, rock on! Oh dear, no, she's been rocked off. Classic operatic warm-up for Jason. Oops. And he's off! Oh dear, right in the solar plexus. Gene on the sucker punch. Let's see how tough this rocker really is.
That's it, Gene!
Oh. Wow, the sucker punch actually seemed to help her out there.
You've got a friend.
A helping hand must be a fellow rocker. Or not.
Almost!
Now, one tenor Jason taking on the four balls. Oh! Well, that's kind of an up and overture. Hope he didn't hurt his leg or toe. You get it? Legato. It's an opera joke. Never mind. So, Gene's time. Not looking too rock and roll at the moment. Can't afford to hang around. Here we go. Oh my goodness. Didn't even touch the sides. Look at that. If that was the aim, she'd have won. It wasn't. And now, Jason, onto the shapeshifter.
This is so very operatic to me.
Down he goes.
Oh, Jason.
Yeah. Rock Chick Gene completes the course in just under 5 minutes.
Rock and roll, baby!
Not really, no. But it's one tenor Jason that has something to sing about, finishing in 2 minutes 30.
The fat lady has sung, it's over.
Goodbye! Next, it's mum of two, Kate from Weatherby. Her 3 and 6-year-old sons, Stanley and Max, made her apply for the show. I'm sure she'll do them proud. Okay, that's not a good start.
Don't underestimate this Yorkshire pudding!
My favourite type of pudding, Yorkshire. Okay! Ooh, a very elegant walk down the ramp. Oh, well, that got her to the bottom quicker, I suppose. Okay, she's up. Oh, she's lost a shoe, but the rest of her is still intact, so far. Here we go. Oh, head smash.
Watch your head!
Yeah, too late. Oh, yeah, say that before it happens, not after. Okay, onto the sucker punch now. Oh, or not onto the sucker punch.
Hey, you haven't started yet!
That's what we call a welcome punch.
Hi!
And that's what we call just not very good. Right, silly mummy Kate finishes in just 2 minutes 23 and is the quickest lady so far. Your boys can officially be proud.
Bradley! Ready for you! Woo!
Now, doing it for the dads is 39-year-old Tony, who has 8 children.
I'm the king of 8, and I'm here to state that everything here has to total 8.
You've got 8 children!
8 children. From 13 down to 10 days.
Can you name them for me?
I can. Aisha, Amira, Adnan, Adil, Aman, Amir, Aliyah, Alina.
He's not in my good books, you know. 8 children, all beginning with the letter A, and not one of them called Amanda.
Well, the octopopper is off. Tony hoping to prove that Dad has still got it. And he gets it, all right in the face. Now he's on to the sweeper. And now he's in. Yeah, that was falling with style. And talking of style, check out those amazing dad shorts. Oh, straight into the mud, so are his shorts.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
If he can handle 8 children, I'm guessing 4 balls shouldn't be too hard.
Everything here has to total 8.
Here we go.
1, 2.
No. Well, Octopopper Tony finishes in 3 minutes 16. Daddy cool, but Daddy not quick.
I'm here to state that everything here has to total 8.
The next 2 competitors are desperate to lift the Total Wipeout trophy, but even more desperate to keep their hair dry. 18-year-old Ron is a lifeguard who can do one-armed press-ups. He has big hair.
Just how fit are you, Ron?
What would you want to see?
Okay.
Ugh, his stomach's all weird and lumpy.
I do run, you do run.
He's up against 26-year-old Tomasz, who's a casino croupier from Poland, via Nottingham. He has spiky hair.
Now, what kind of thing have you been doing in preparation for that?
I just try to stand in front of the mirror, I'm trying to look good, and then as long as I'm going to look good and I'm comfortable with what I'm wearing, then should be okay, I think.
Ron's first go. The question is, how long will that hair stay dry? Ooh!
His hair is safe. It's dry so far.
Yeah, this is quick and dry. He jumps, ducks, and... Oh, look at that! That's how it's done. Now, Thomas, will it be hair today, gone tomorrow? Well, he ducks the first. And again, he's across with hair intact too. Maybe this is the answer. Ron's still dry, but judging by today's big ball standards, his big hair could be in big trouble here. Oh, he's onto the fourth ball. You're joking. No, he's made it. Wow. A superb crossing from Ron. Maybe this is the answer, desperation to keep your hair dry, but he does. Can Thomas get across without a hair wash too? Here we go. Oh, no, the hair has taken a beating. Oh, he looks normal. His hair's been all flattened, but his time is still looking good. Can he make it across the shapeshifter? He's going for the triangle. In and out. Get that man some straighteners. His spirits are up. Unfortunately, his hair obviously isn't. But Thomas the Tank Top is the quickest qualifier so far.
Hold on,
1 minute 40. Will Ron's hair fit through the shapeshifter? It's through! And he's holding on. Is he going to make it all the way around? I am genuinely amazed. He has. Here's his chance. He's done it! Across the balls, first to beat the shapeshifter, and with a time of only 1 minute 13 seconds, he's beaten Thomas and is now top of the leaderboard too. All that and a completely dry hairdo. I'm genuinely staggered.
6-pack plus an athlete equals success in Total Wipeout.
Never mind, Thomas.
I just, you know, actually I look different with this way. I look different now, which I absolutely love. It's quite often I wear my hairstyle like that, and which is quite good because sometimes people don't recognize me with hair down. One day hair down, one day the hair up. It depends on my mood. So yeah, all is good. It's all good.
18 contestants down, two still to go. And this is Emma, a 26-year-old forensic psychologist who has a score to settle.
Now, is there anything that you can draw on from the world of forensic psychology, Emma, that you can use to your advantage out there today?
Well, my thesis is actually on revenge, so those big red bulls better watch out because I won't get mad, I'll just get even.
Yeah, I've no idea why Emma wants revenge. The qualifier hasn't done anything wrong, has it? Okay, hasn't it?
Right in the face!
Yeah, so will Emma get even on the big red balls. One, two, wet.
Nothing forensic about that. Get
even. No, she's got even more wet than before. Oh, yeah, I think the qualifier may have won this one, Emma. Emma completes the course in just over 2 minutes. From one PhD student to, Alex.
Yeah! I'm joined now at the top of the course by a very excitable young man who's determined to put his village on the map. This is Alex, and he's a trainee maths teacher, I think. Alex, how you doing?
Hello, Amanda. I'm very excited. I'm going to win this course for my village. Farrington Gurney.
Will this be the most dramatic thing Farrington Gurney has ever seen?
Definitely top 10, definitely top 10. But we had village pantomime a few weekends ago, and I was in it as well.
Who did you play, Alex?
I played the village idiot.
Yeah, I think his village should be on the map, and it's not because I want to go there. But Alex is ploughing on after that slip, and oh no, he's down again. But he's still going, avoiding the sweeper arm, and avoiding the smash door.
Alex got straight out of bed and came in his pyjamas this morning.
Alex approaching the balls. Those mud-drenched pyjamas probably weighing him down. That was amazing. He flew across those balls. He's still on. Just one more jump. He's done it! He's certainly put his village on the map now, and for all the very best of reasons. With that amazing ball crossing, Alex finishes in a very impressive 1 minute 41. What a talented idiot!
And look how well you did!
I did a big red ball!
Yeah, you did!
Farrington Gurney's first ever big red ball person.
Farrington Gurney, you should be proud.
Thank you. Yes!
Right, let's have a look at the final leaderboard. Hairdo Ron Ron is head, shoulders and hairdo above the rest. Thomas the Tank Top is second and Alex the Village Idiot is in third. Don't Get Mad Get Emma is the best performing lady in sixth. Silly Mummy Kate is in eighth and One Tenor Jason sings his way into ninth. Second Class Michael, Mrs. Eve and Fun Size Tash are in 10th, 11th and 12th.
Unfortunately, the fat lady has sung for One Tenor Jason. He picked up an injury on the qualifier and has withdrawn from the competition. That means Tough Cookie Kim pops up from 13th to take his place in Double Cross. So the qualifying qualifiers have qualified, which earns them the title of qualifiers. This means we say goodbye to the non-qualifying qualifiers who didn't qualify, earning them the title of losers.
There are places I'll remember all my life, though some have changed, some forever, not for better. Some have gone, and some remain.
Double Cross works like this. The 12 competitors line up over there before making a run for it along any one of the green gangways into the middle. Once in the centre, they can only use the single red gangway to reach the finish. The fact that the gangways rotate in one direction, whilst a big red cross rotates in the other, means this obstacle is technically categorised as really tricky. First six across qualify for the next round. So let's meet today's double crossers. Fastest in the qualifier and biggest in the hair, it's Hairdo Ron Ron.
Alex, mate, you got your pyjamas on. Should've stayed in bed, man.
Okay. It's pole vault time for Tom as the tank top.
This is the Polish power!
Third fastest in the qualifier, it's Alex the village idiot.
I may be wearing girls' pyjamas, but I'm still the most macho man here!
I think Alex is great. I like him. Then there's quite good Kev and Mr. Philip.
Eve, I beat you in the first round. Now I'm going to beat you in the second round.
Don't get mad, Get Emma is next. And hold on to your hats, it's Nitro Nathan. Then there's silly mummy Kate.
Don't double-cross this Yorkshire pudding!
I'd never double-cross a Yorkshire pudding. And that's Mrs. Eve.
Philip, I'm going to beat you on this one! If not, I'm going to beat you when I get home!
Then it's second-class Michael, fun-sized Tash, and finally Jason's replacement, tough cookie Kim.
Can't shout.
My motto in life is keep calm and carry on. That's so not going to work here, so I suggest keep calm, carry on, and run like crazy. It's double cross. Are you all ready?
Yeah!
3, 2, 1.
The game is afoot, but nobody's moving their feet. Tash gives it a go. Oh, just a tester run, maybe. Emma. Oh. Ow. Oh, I think that was Kate. This thing is brutal. Hairdo Ron Ron. Lasted as long as his nickname. Remember, they can only use the green gangways to get into the middle. Second class Michael now, and oh! Ooh. Collecting the post right in the ankle. Right, it's Ron again. Come on. Oh! Yeah. Fastest qualifier, having no luck so far. This is Mr. Philip. Getting closer. Michael now is into the centre.
Finally.
Well, what's this? Tom as the tank top has joined Michael in the middle. Nitro Nathan now. Oh, very close. Quite good, Kev. Bolts for it. He's there as well. Things are getting a little crowded in the centre now. Remember, they're all just waiting for that red gangway to come round. It's the only way off. Oh, Michael! Got one foot under the red gangway, but then just sort of fell off. Kevin attempts the exit. Oh. That was close. Kevin almost made it across, but then there was a pirouette somersault flip of a fall.
I can do it! Yes, you can. There's no such thing as can.
Possibly. Thomas alone in the middle. Come on, people. Oh, Nathan heard me. Yes, he's on. He's on, he's off. He's on. He's still on. Mr. Phillip's back for more. Bit of a limbo. Oh. Mr. Philip is trying everything. But where's Mrs. Eve? Finally, Thomas heads for the water. Getting off double cross is definitely difficult. Michael now, third time lucky, hurdles the crosses and misses the middle completely, and in goes Nathan too. Ooh, Ron, into the middle. Surely he'll be able to do this. Don't get mad, Get Emma wants to join in, and she's there, just. Kevin again now, and he's there. Michael too. This is good middle management or something.
Pile up.
Oh, yeah. They're all now waiting for the optimum gap betwixt Red Gangway and Red Cross. That's the time to run for the finish. Kim piles on too. Kevin sees his chance, looking good. Quite good, Kev. He's the first to qualify for the next round.
Go on, the Irish.
Ooh, out of nowhere, Nathan speeds across to the finish line too.
We have Nathan.
Nitro Nathan is through. Meanwhile, Thomas has reached the centre and now Eve's chasing her husband. She's got the sweeper arm, but oh no! She's hanging on. Eve's position is rapidly becoming untenable and she's been dropped. But her husband is still up. Still in the middle.
Who? You?
Tense now, tense. Michael, second assault on the exit beam. Jumps and oh, not enough. Four places in the next round are still up for grabs. Who's got the legs to do it? Thomas making his move. Oh, superb. What a finish. Three down, three to go.
Usually it's around here that it all gets very fast and frantic. Tash into the middle. Hairdo Ron, run. Can he make it? Yes! No! I feel for Ron, I really do. That was close. Oh! Kim sets off from the starting podium. Lovely skip and into the middle. But it's too crowded for Emma. She's off and leaps across the finish line. Well, actually, the next bit's the finish line there. Emma is through to the next round. So two places remain. Will they go to Michael, Kim, Philip, Eve, Ron, Tash, Alex or Kate? Here comes Michael. Makes the middle again. And that's Mr. Philip. Ooh, takes one to the legs, but soldiers on to the middle, leaving his wife behind. Michael's got his eyes on the prize and just makes that jump. But Philip's hot on his heels. And like that, it's all over. Philip and Michael are through to the next round, joining Kevin, Emma, Thomas and Nathan, but not Philip's wife, Eve. And a huge upset for Ron, the fastest in the qualifier. He's out. And his hair's wet. Oh.
In years to come, that edition of Double Cross will claim its rightful place among the epic tales of yore. The Odyssey, Beowulf, and my famous Shaggy Dog story about the ticket inspector who keeps throwing passengers through the train window. It's a belter. But for now, it's time to wave a solemn goodbye to the six unlucky souls who fell on the long, long march to victory. Okay, so there's this ticket inspector, right, and he's walking along the train, comes to the first passenger.
Double Cross is madness. I couldn't jump the sweeper if I tried, so literally had to be flash Tash or no Tash.
Nearly made it once, but yeah, it's where the cookie crumbles. Pretty gutted.
I was trying the hardest and I was just diving and going for it. It's the best I could do. It was a total disaster, wasn't it?
I really, really wanted to beat Philip, because he always claims himself being better than me, but I guess maybe it's true. Aye, aye, aye. It hurt. Yeah, I wanted to do it, I wanted to get through, I wanted to do the next round, but these things happen, I can't do anything about it.
What you see here is a broken man. I hope I haven't let down my village, my mum, but it was not a good idea wearing pyjamas on the Total Wipeout course.
Today's Terragoround is brought to you by the good people at Total Wipeout Airways. We hope you've enjoyed your flight. Contestants must jog on the revolving turntable, avoiding the spinning fickle fingers of fate, as well as all the lost luggage items thrown by the Terra Twins. It's broken down into three heats, and each time the last person standing goes through to the Wipeout Zone.
Do you know what I've just spotted? Yep, that's right. Too many contestants left in Total Wipeout. Just gonna have to get rid of half of them. Terragoround should do it. Are you all ready? They think 3, 2, 1.
Let's meet the terrified go-rounders. Can the postie with the mostie send himself through to the final? It's second class Michael.
An express delivery.
Behind every great man, there's a great woman. Although in this man's case, she's way behind on the loser's bench. It's Mr. Philip.
I'm gonna rip you to shreds.
He was first to jig over the double cross, but will the luck of the Irish carry him all the way to the final? It's quite good, Kev.
That's the most fun I've had with my clothes on in ages.
She's giving the guys a run for their money and hoping to take sweet revenge on the Terragoround. It's Don't Get Mad, Get Emma.
And it's time for revenge.
He's the fastest qualifier left and the fastest talker ever.
Which I absolutely love it. Quite often I wear my hairstyle like that.
Yep, no idea. But will his dreams of 10 grand fall flat as his hair? It's Thomas the Tank Top. And finally, he's all revved up for a few laps on the Terragoround, but will he be in pole position for the Wipeout Zone or just exhausted? It's Nitro Nathan.
Well, this is going to be a total whitewash.
So the frantic, fast-paced fun begins.
Admittedly, not all that frantic just yet, but then the Terror Twins haven't started lobbing their luggage yet. Six remaining contestants, only three places in the final. There they go. Hold all to the head for Thomas, that'll ruin his hat hair. Oh, look, there goes the teddy, my favourite. Ouch! They all seem to be coping well, but any second now, those fingers of fate will come into play.
Oh, go on, Kevin, using the speed of flames to kick the box out of the way.
Oh, and here they come. Oh, good step over, but Philip's gone in off the front, and there's trouble at the back.
Oh!
Thomas is in. Lifted high off the turntable and dunked in the pool, he's out of the game, at least for this heat. So, four left standing, here comes a finger. Oh, and Emma gets flipped and dunked head first, down to three now, preparing to jump. Oh, everyone's down. They must stay this side of the punch bags. Back on their feet, but Michael's in trouble, and Kevin's gone in. Good distance, too. All of that means Nitro Nathan is the last one standing and the first one through to today's Wipeout Zone. Second heat, five competitors left and the Terror Twins have got a new trolley full of luggage, all locally sourced. About time for those fingers to start. This could be carnage. All the glamour's over, but there's trouble at the back. Phillip's first in again. Synchronised bar work from Philip and Michael, but Philip just lost his balance. He's out of this heat. Second finger gets Michael that time, just Emma, Kevin and Thomas left standing. Ooh, stumble from Kevin, but he's back to his feet, great recovery. High jump from Thomas, but this is strong work from everyone now. Oh, Emma's down, get up! No, she's under the punch bags and out of this heat. So, Thomas and Kevin, who's going through to the Wipeout Zone? Looks like Kevin's struggling a bit there. There's no let-up in this game. He's down, he's gone, and Thomas is through. Thomas, you're through to the final. Thomas, you need to get off. Now, it's finished. You need to get... Hello! There you go. Concentrating a bit too hard, maybe. For second class Michael, Mr. Philip, quite good Kev, and don't get mad, get Emma. This is the last chance to avoid elimination. Only one can go through to the Wipeout. And they're off again. Ooh, Terror Twins going hell for leather, throwing all their toys out of the prop. Now, thinking about it, I'm not sure this is safe, because those bags are a real trip hazard. As are the fingers of fate. Emma's on, but she's hanging on in there. Kevin, almost gone. No, he has gone. No, yes, no. No, gone. Kevin is out of Total Wipeout. Emma's on her knees. Can she recover it? Nope, she's out of the game too. It's now between Philip and Michael for that last remaining spot in the Wipeout Zone. And that finger is fast. Philip's fallen, and in the blink of an eye, it's all over. Mr. Philip is out of Total Wipeout. But a first-class performance from second-class Michael bags him the third and final spot in today's Wipeout Zone. Which means it's time to wave goodbye to three brave competitors. She came here for revenge, but the Terror Go-Round had the last laugh. Farewell, don't get mad, get Emma. Quite good wasn't quite good enough for quite good Kev. And although he's leaving us, he can at least be with his wife once more, over on the spectators' bench. Farewell, Mr. Philip.
So there are only moments to go now before today's thrilling Wipeout Zone begins. I'm not entirely sure how long a moment is, but it just so happens I've brought my Victorian momentometer. So, yeah, 3 moments, 2 moments, 1 moment, Wipeout Zone! Yeah, momentometer's fast. It'll be coming up any time now, I imagine. Unless...
I'll tell you what I'm going to bring to this final. One word, bottle.
It's just so hard. There is nothing in the world that can pay for this.
Just unbelievable experience, and I'm never going to forget the experience for the rest of my life. I never would expect I could actually get into the final. And my family is going to be really proud of me, and especially my mom.
At the start, I didn't really expect much from him, but he's done a lot better than I thought.
He's a fit lad, but will he bottle it in the final? I think he will.
People have thought that I'm going to be rubbish because of what I was wearing. And actually, I'm here. It's just amazing.
It nearly all went wrong, but I found my rhythm, and I knew I'd come good in the end. And it's game on.
I think he's got really, really good potential because he doesn't give up and never stop.
I'm not far off half a day. So I feel I've got the better of him for this one.
To win here tonight would mean everything to me. You know, if you get the title of Total Wipeout champion, no one's going to take that away from you.
If I win tonight, I will feel so good about myself. At the age of 17, I was diagnosed with cancer. From that experience, going through everything that I had to do, and then here we are, years later, I'm back fighting fit, now I'm ready to beat this.
This is for all the old boys, life begins at 40.
This is my time, I'm here ready to win this.
This is the biggest challenge in my life and I feel so excited.
This is going to be fantastic.
Three guys on the road to destiny and there's no speed limit. Who's in the fast lane and who's on the hard shoulder? Waiting for the tow truck. This is the Wipeout Zone and Michael is the first to brave it.
Can second-class Michael deliver yet another first-class performance?
Cometh the hour, cometh the Rasta postman.
Yeah, that old chestnut. Right, here he goes.
Special delivery!
So Michael gets today's final started. He'll be setting the benchmark to beat. A swim to the rapid climb. And once he sets foot on the rapid climb, he's got 10 seconds to scale it, else a tidal wave will be released.
That's it! Over the garden gate, Michael!
Woo! He's up, so the countdown begins. Michael's doing well so far. Tidal wave defeated. Now to the seesaw of truth. Michael's charging across it. Yes, keeps his balance. Will he be able to weave his way across the crazy sweeper? This claims a lot. Oh no! He's fallen! Michael totally misjudged the sweeper there, as so many have done before, and he's paid for it. Vital seconds lost. The final straight now, though. The turntables safely onto the first. Now to the pillars of no return. No! Oh! That leap was way too short. A second big slip. Michael now needs to summon a final burst of energy to make this one last jump. He's there. 2 minutes 41. Not bad, but definitely beatable.
Come on out, my lovely postman.
Hello there.
How are you feeling after that performance?
I'm feeling 40 years old, actually. Oh, it was hard work.
Well, listen, Michael, well done, because you did that in 2 minutes and 41 seconds, which isn't bad for someone who fell off a couple of times.
That's right.
Listen, Tomas is up next, so let's watch.
Okay.
He's got a hedgehog under that helmet. It's Tomas.
Everybody lives your dream!
Woo! I think this is more of a nightmare. And here he goes. Now, he doesn't yet know how Michael got on, so he's just going to be concentrating on going as fast as he can.
Come on, Thomas!
Ah, wonderful sportsmanship from Michael. Let's see if that lasts. Thomas getting a refreshing blast of water in the face, but now he's up. And the tidal wave countdown has started. Ooh, little slip. But he's up again and now bounding up with the aid of the banister.
Pole on the pole.
Yeah, it's more of a beam, actually. Thomas taking things very cautiously here. Up to the balance point. Tips it slowly. He's cleared it. Taking no chances. Right, crunch time. This is where Michael's first slip-up came. Ducks. Thomas looking very comfortable up there. He he's cleared it. Just about. Yes, very slick. Well, just the turntables to go now. He's on to the first, lines up his next jump. No! Oh! Same place as Michael. Thomas slams into a pillar of no return, and there is no returning from that. Oh, wait, seems there is. Thomas, nearly there. This is quicker than Michael. 1 minute 44, faster by nearly a minute.
Thomas, you started out the qualifier all bunny ears and bow ties, and now look at you, you're all serious. And that serious performance has just made you beat Michael. Well done.
Oh my God, thank you very much.
Michael, good luck, my man. Go well.
What can you do? My 48-year-old legs caught up with me in the end.
All right, see you later, Michael. Tomas, Nathan's up next, and yours is the time to beat. Let's watch. Can I have a kiss?
Nitro Nathan prepares for his final lap.
Stink, Max. Stink.
I don't know what that means, but let's not question him now. He's busy. Time for the big finale. So now it's a straight battle between Nathan and Thomas. And while Nathan doesn't know it, 1 minute 44 is the time he must beat if he is to win today's competition and the £10,000 prize. And remember, Thomas did make one slip-up, so an error-free run from Nathan will probably be enough.
He's up.
He is, and the clock starts ticking now. But Nitro Nathan accelerating up the rapid climb. Oh, that's no problem. Right, seesaw time. Ooh, it looks slippy, but Nathan is looking well balanced. He's across. Just. Now the crazy sweep. Nathan waits for his moment.
Careful, Nathan. Oh.
He's dashing. Ooh, some sensible ducking. But slow to get back up.
Ow!
Near miss there. Up a bit quicker this time, and yes! Right, turntables. Thomas and Michael both fell here, so a clean run now, and the title is Nathan's. Yes! No!
Oh, no!
Oh, that's the third strike today for the Pillars of No Return. Nathan clambers up the ladder, but he's gonna need a miracle now to beat Thomas's time.
Get up! Get up! Get up!
Oh, every second! A great run, but 10 seconds too slow today.
Nathan, come on out, my lovely. What a fantastic run from you.
Oh, that was so hard. The ladders are so hard. But I've done my best, that's all I can do.
Tomas, I know this means an awful lot to you too. Tomas, you are the Total Wipeout champion tonight! Hard luck, Nathan!
So, today's winner of the Total Wipeout trophy and £10,000 is Thomas Wisniewski, a 26-year-old croupier from Nottingham. And if you've enjoyed Thomas's performance half as much as me, you'll want one of these! A Thomas tribute hairpiece, available nationwide in Hammond's Party Emporium. That's it for today's show. From Amanda and me, it's goodbye. Thomas the Tank Top is second, and Alex the Village Idiot is in third. Don't Get Mad, Get Emma is the best performing lady in sixth. Silly Mummy Kate is in eighth, and One Tenor Jason sings his way into ninth. Second Class Michael, Mrs. Eve and Fun Size Tash are in 10th, 11th and 12th.
Unfortunately, the fat lady has sung for One Tenor Jason. He picked up an injury on the qualifier and has withdrawn from the competition. That means Tough Cookie Kim pops up from 13th to take his place in Double Cross. So the qualifying qualifiers have qualified, which earns them the title of qualifiers. This means we say goodbye to the non-qualifying qualifiers who didn't qualify, earning them the title of losers.
There are places I'll remember all my life, though some have changed, some forever, not for better. Some have gone, and some remain.
Double Cross works like this. The 12 competitors line up over there before making a run for it along any one of the green gangways into the middle. Once in the centre, they can only use the single red gangway to reach the finish. The fact that the gangways rotate in one direction whilst a big red cross rotates in the other means this obstacle is technically categorised as really tricky. First six across qualify for the next round. So let's meet today's double crossers. Fastest in the qualifier and biggest in the hair, it's Hairdo Ron Ron.
Alex, mate, you got your pyjamas on. Just stayed in bed, man.
Okay. It's pole vault time for Tomas the Tank Top.
This is the Polish power!
Third fastest in the qualifier, it's Alex the Village Idiot.
I may be wearing girls' pyjamas, but I'm still the most macho man here!
I think Alex is great. I like him. Then there's Quite Good Kev and Mr. Philip.
Eve, I beat you in the first round. Now I'm going to beat you in the second round.
Don't get mad, Get Emma is next. And hold on to your hats, it's Nitro Nathan. Then there's Silly Mummy Kate.
Don't double-cross this Yorkshire pudding!
I'd never double-cross a Yorkshire pudding. And that's Mrs. Eve.
Philip, I'm going to beat you on this one! If not, I'm going to beat you when I get home!
Then it's second-class Michael, fun-sized Tash, and finally Jason's replacement, Tough Cookie Kim.
Can't show.
My motto in life is keep calm and carry on. That's so not going to work here, so I... My next contestant, this is Michael from St. Helens, and he's a postman. Michael, how you doing?
I am aiming to become a legend on the mail-delivering circuit of St. Helens. And I'm not just talking St. Helens, Amanda. This could propel me to the big time. I'm talking the outskirts as well. I'm talking Haydock, Billinge, Rainford, Thatto Heath.
So, 40-year-old, slightly terrifying postie Michael is the first to tackle today's qualifier. He talks the talk, but will he deliver on the course? Well, he's quickly across the pontoons, which means he's about to come to the first stop on his route. A brand new addition to the Total Wipeout course, the Wall Street Smash. It's three obstacles in one. Contestants must keep one eye on the sweeping up, the other eye on keeping their balance, and then the other eye on the giant pieces of wall that swing out and smash you in the face. Here we go. Oh, special delivery.
Oh, watch your head, Michael.
That Wall Street Smash doesn't like unexpected mail, so unexpected mail, spelled differently, you see, Michael, is stamped and sent straight to his destination, Muddy Waterville. Painful lesson to learn, he won't be doing that again in a hurry. Here he goes. Watch out for the... Oh, be careful of the... And the... Then there's the... Yeah. Oh, no. No, he's in. This is tricky, isn't it? Next, it punches. It punches, it squirts paint, and it punches some more. Here we go. Well, oh, he's ducked the paint, but not the fists. Avoided damaging his package, but it's not really an express delivery so far. Now, for the part of his route that he's dreading. Four big red spheres that don't know the meaning of the words do not bet. The big red balls. Oh, yeah, that works.
Oh, buddy!
Ball one. And he's in. Second class fall.
That was rubbish!
Maybe he'll have a bit more luck on the final obstacle. It's the shapeshifter. Up the ladder. Down the slide. And which window should we go through today? The square window. The triangle window. Or the round window. that's right. Probably none of them. So the postman has nearly reached his final destination. All he has to do now is post himself through one of the holes. Should be easy for Michael. Here we go.
Oh, no.
A postman missing the hole.
Started to wonder if anyone in St. Helens has ever received any post at all. Second class Michael posts a time of 2 minutes 30. So will the cage fighting chef hit it off with the Wall Street smash?
No, it was just Kim that was hit off.
Yeah, well, they say love hurts, and that did. Can the last contestant win the heart of the 10-foot foam bachelor? She's a dental practice manager that says she's mad as a box of frogs. Number 3 is always the wacky one. Meet Debbie from Newport. Will she fall head over heels? Well, I'd say, yeah, pretty obviously. But on the walls being all bashful. I think true love has been found. Debbie is dizzy in love. Although maybe somebody should check that's not concussion. Could this be a love that lasts forever? Oh no, she's up and doing a runner. Looks like the Wall Street smash is going home alone tonight.
Lonely, I'm Mr. Lonely.
So let's see how their efforts have affected the current leaderboard. Quite Good Kev has now jigged into the top spot. Fun Size Tash jumps into sixth, and Tough Cookie Kim is only seconds behind in seventh. In ninth, it's Lights Camera Jonathan, whilst at the foot of the table is Box of Frogs Debbie and Cats Love Georgia in 11th and 12th.
Time for a clash of culture. Now, I'm a big fan of rock music, like Foo Fighters, Led Zepp, AC/DC. But I'm also a big fan of opera music, like that World Cup one that Pavarotti did. Just one cornetto. Well, next, it's a rocker versus an operaist. I'm going to really enjoy this. In fact, I'm going to put my glasses on to enjoy it and then pour myself a crystal glass of vintage champagne.
Doing it for the opera people, it's 40-year-old Jason.
Truly no other they can compare.
And in the rock corner, it's 53-year-old Gene.
I shall win.
Rock and roll fantasy!
Of that have no doubt.
Rock and roll fantasy!
Yeah, rock on!
Oh dear, no, she's been rocked off. Classic operatic warm-up for Jason. Oops. And he's off! Oh dear! Right in the solar plexus. Gene on the sucker punch. Let's see how tough this rocker really is.
That's it, Gene!
Yeah! Oh! Wow, the sucker punch actually seemed to help her out there.
You've got a friend.
A helping hand must be a fellow rocker. Next, it's 25-year-old petrol head Nathan from Kent.
So, Nathan, you clearly feel the need for speed. But how speedy are you going to be out there on those big red balls?
That's going to be faster than that. That's faster than that.
Everyone's heard of Total Wipeout, but this is going to be a total white wash.
That's a bad thing, isn't it? Okay. Right. Well, softly. Catchy. Well, nothing. But he's up quickly and puts his foot on the pedal, accelerating. Thankfully, there's no speed cameras here. Good manoeuvres from Nathan. Oh, he's cleared. No. One slip and he was in. Who's gonna drive you home? It looked like he'd regained control, but he swerves into the hard shoulder. Now he's got a wet shoulder as well. Onto the sucker punch. Oh, yeah, that was harsh. Oh, that was a proper whack. Forcing Nathan into a quick muddy pit stop. Drive slow, homie. Say quick. Right, he's got the green light for the big red balls. Go, 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 go. Yes, no, yes, no. False start.
Not so Formula One now.
But Nitro Nathan lives up to his speedy boast, finishing in 2 minutes 16. Not bad. So, six runners in, and it's Mr. Philip that's taken the early lead with Nitro Nathan hot on his heels. Second class Michael shares third with Mrs. Eve, and Zoe not from Spain is in fifth. Awesome Amita is not living up to her name, sat in sixth.
For years, I've been pitching Total Wipeout the movie, but due to lack of funding, lack of interest, me not having got around to writing the script, Angelina Jolie not returning any of my calls, and the whole restraining order thing, it's remained a mere pipe dream until today. For now, I have the budget. Well, ish. And a leading actor, 28-year-old Jonathan from Cumbria. So, here goes. I've always wanted to do this. Action! Oh, doesn't work. Action! No, really, it's not working. That stings! It's broken.
In a land far, far away, well, a 14-hour flight, and then a queue with customs. He was an actor from Cumbria.
Feel the rhythm! Feel the rhyme! Get on up!
Their times are very close, so the War of the Wedded will be settled on the shapeshifter. Bragging rights and a year of washing up at stake here. Eve goes for it. She's in! She's out! Which means it's all down to this one last slide. Never has so much rested on what can only be described as, well, playground equipment. Philip's lost his headband, but will he keep his pride? Nope! There it goes, into the water. And this was virtually identical to Eve's effort. It's like they were meant to be together, isn't it? It's beautiful, that.
Yeah.
Spiritually linked. Mrs. Eve finishes in 2 minutes 36, but it's Mr. Philip who wears the trousers and a smug grin, finishing in just under 2 minutes.
Woo! D-I-V-O-R-C-E.
This is air traffic controller Zoe Spain.
Is it a bird? Is it a plane? No, it's Zoe Spain.
Yeah, she's not from Spain, she's from Egham.
What a cool, big, important job you have to clear the skies of danger and to guide jumbo jets into land.
Actually, it's quite a small little airport in Surrey, looking at the Surrey Downs, called Fair Oaks. It's not that big.
Zoe Spain, who's not from Spain, takes off down the runway and... Oh, eject! Eject! Too late.
That was a bit of a crash landing. Let's fly,
let's fly away. Now she's up against two giant propellers. Her aviation skills might just come in handy here. One, good start. No, oh dear, no. She's in. In case of an emergency, Zoe is pointing out the nearest exit to your right, down the steps, and into the muddy water. Now it's the sucker punch. Will it put the pain into Zoe Spain? Oh, well, so far, so good. Zoe taking every punch firmly on the chin.
Let's go!
Very brave or very stupid. It's brave because she's made it. Zoe's face must be black and blue and yellow and a bit orange, is that? Mother looks at it. Yeah. Not sure she can take much more of this punishment. So, she's at the top of the slide. She slides down. Oh!
This is... No, and now she's... Oh, no! Oh, dear.
Hold on, hang tight!
I'm leaving on a jet plane.
Yeah, but, you know, no pain, no gain. And with all that pain, Zoe has gained a good time and now needs to gain some medical attention. Next is 25-year-old petrol head Nathan from Kent. Michael, second assault on the exit beam, jumps and... Oh, not enough. Four places in the next round are still up for grabs. Who's got the legs to do it? Thomas, making his move. Oh, superb, what a finish. Three down, three to go. Usually it's around here that it all gets very fast and frantic. Tash into the middle. Hairdo Ron, run. Can he make it? Yes! No! I feel for Ron, I really do. That was close. Oh. Kim sets off from the starting podium. Lovely skip and into the middle. But it's too crowded for Emma. She's off and leaps across the finish line. Well, actually, the next bit's the finish line there. Emma is through to the next round. So two places remain. Will they go to Michael, Kim, Philip, Eve, Ron, Tash, Alex, or Kate? Here comes Michael. Makes the middle again. And that's Mr. Philip. Oh, takes one to the legs, but soldiers on to the middle, leaving his wife behind. Michael's got his eyes on the prize and just makes that jump. But Philip's hot on his heels. And like that, it's all over. Philip and Michael are through to the next round, joining Kevin, Emma, Thomas and Nathan, but not Philip's wife, Eve. And a huge upset for Ron, the fastest in the qualifier. He's out. And his hair's wet. Aw.
In years to come, that edition of Double Cross will claim its rightful place among the epic tales of yore. The Odyssey, Beowulf, and my famous shaggy dog story about the ticket inspector who keeps throwing passengers through the train window. It's a belter. But for now, it's time to wave a solemn goodbye to the six unlucky souls who fell on the long, long march to victory. Okay, so there's this ticket inspector, right, and he's walking along the train, comes to the first passenger.
Double Cross is madness. I couldn't jump the sweeper if I tried, so literally had to be Flash Tash or no Tash.
Nearly made it once, but yeah, it's where the cookie crumbles. Pretty gutted.
I was trying the hardest and I was just diving and going for it. It's the best I could do. It was a total disaster, wasn't it?
I really, really wanted to beat Philip, because he always claims himself being better than me, but I guess maybe it's true. Aye, aye, aye. It hurt. Yeah, I wanted to do it, I wanted to get through, I wanted to do the next round, but these things happen, I can't do anything about it.
What you see here is a broken man. I hope I haven't let down my village, my mum, but...
Maybe it's true. Aye, aye, aye. It hurt. Yeah, I wanted to do it, I wanted to get through, I wanted to do the next round, but these things happen, I can't do anything about it.
What you see here is a broken man. I hope I haven't let down my village, my mum, but it was not a good idea wearing pyjamas on the Total Wipeout course.
Today's Terror Go Round is brought to you by the good people at Total Wipeout Airways. We hope you've enjoyed your flight. Contestants must jog on the revolving turntable, avoiding the spinning fickle fingers of fate, as well as all the lost luggage items thrown by the Terror Twins. It's broken down into three heats, and each time the last person standing goes through to the Wipeout Zone.
Do you know what I've just spotted? Yep, that's right. Too many contestants left in Total Wipeout. I'm just gonna have to get rid of half of them. Terror Go Round should do it. Are you all ready? Woo! They think. 3, 2, 1!
Let's meet the terrified Go Rounders. Can the postie with the mostie send himself through to the final? It's second class Michael.
An express delivery!
Behind every great man, there's a great woman. Although in this man's case, she's way behind on the loser's bench, it's Mr. Philip.
I'm gonna rip you to shreds.
He was first to jig over the double cross, but will the luck of the Irish carry him all the way to the final? It's quite good, Kev.
That's the most fun I've had with my clothes on in ages.
She's giving the guys a run for their money and hoping to take sweet revenge on the Terror Go Round. It's Don't Get Mad, Get Emma.
And it's time for revenge!
He's the fastest qualifier left and the fastest talker ever.
Which I absolutely love it. Quite often I wear my hairstyle like that.
No idea. But will his dreams of 10 grand fall flat as his hair? It's Thomas the Tank Top. And finally, he's all revved up for a few laps on the Terror Go Round, but will he be in pole position for the Wipeout Zone or just exhausted? It's Nitro Nathan.
Well, this is going to be a total whitewash.
So the frantic, fast-paced fun begins. Admittedly, not all that frantic just yet, but then the Terra Twins haven't started lobbing their luggage yet. Six remaining contestants, only three places in the final. And there they go. Hold all to the head for Thomas, that'll ruin his hat hair. No, look, there goes the Teddy, my favourite. Ouch! They all seem to be coping well, but any second now, those fingers of fate will come into play.
Oh, go on, Kevin, using the speed of flames to kick the box out of the way.
10-foot foam bachelor. She's a dental practice manager that says she's mad as a box of frogs. Number three is always the wacky one. Meet Debbie from Newport. Will she fall head over heels? Well, I'd say, yeah. Yeah, pretty obviously. But on the walls being all bashful. I think true love has been found. Debbie is dizzy in love. Although maybe somebody should check that's not concussion. Could this be a love that lasts forever? Oh no, she's up and doing a runner. Looks like the Wall Street Smash is going home alone tonight.
Lonely, I'm Mr. Lonely. I have nobody.
So let's see how their efforts have affected the current leaderboard. Quite good Kev has now jigged into the top spot. Fun-sized Tash jumps into sixth, and tough cookie Kim is only seconds behind in seventh. In ninth, it's lights, camera, Jonathan, whilst at the foot of the table is Box of Frogs Debbie and Cats Love Georgia in 11th and 12th.
Time for a clash of culture. Now, I'm a big fan of rock music, like Foo Fighters, Led Zepp, AC/DC. But I'm also a big fan of opera music, like that World Cup one that Pavarotti did. Just one cornetto. Well, next, it's a rocker versus an operaist. I'm going to really enjoy this. In fact, I'm going to put my glasses on to enjoy it and then pour myself a crystal glass of vintage champagne.
Doing it for the opera people, it's 40-year-old Jason.
Truly no other they can compare.
And in the rock corner, it's 53-year-old Gene.
Rock and roll by the share!
I shall win.
Rock and roll by the share!
Of that have no doubt.
Rock and roll by the share!
Yeah, rock on! Oh dear, no, she's been rocked off. Classic operatic warm-up for Jason. Oops. And he's off! Oh dear, right in the solar plexus. Gene on the sucker punch. Let's see how tough this rocker really is.
That's it, Gene!
Oh, wow, the sucker punch actually seemed to help her out there.
You've got a friend.
A helping hand must be a fellow rocker. Or not.
Almost!
Now, one tenor Jason taking on the four balls. Oh! Well, that's kind of an up and overture. Hope he didn't hurt his leg or toe. You get it, Lagarde?
Audience thing, now. Let's join Amanda at the top of the course with today's first contestant. Paul McCartney. It's genius.
Special delivery for the qualifier. As I'm joined now by my next contestant, this is Michael from St. Helens, and he's a postman. Michael, how are you doing?
I am aiming to become a legend on the mail delivering circuit of St. Helens. And I'm not just talking St. Helens, Amanda. This could propel me to the big time. I'm talking the outskirts as well. I'm talking Haydock, Billinge, Rainford, Thatto Heath.
So, 40-year-old, slightly terrifying postie Michael is the first to tackle today's qualifier. He talks the talk, but will he deliver on the course? Well, he's quickly across the pontoons, which means he's about to come to the first stop on his route. A brand new addition to the Total Wipeout course, the Wall Street Smash. It's three obstacles in one. Contestants must keep one eye on the sweeping up, the other eye on keeping their balance, and then the other eye on the giant pieces of wall that swing out and smash you in the face. Here we go. Oh, special delivery.
Oh, watch your head, Michael.
That Wall Street smash doesn't like unexpected mail. So, unexpected mail, spelled differently, you see, Michael, is stamped and sent straight to his destination, Muddy Waterville. Painful lesson to learn. He won't be doing that again in a hurry. Here he goes. Watch out for the... Oh, be careful of the... And the... Then there's the... Yeah. Oh, no. No, he's in. This is tricky, isn't it? Next, it punches. It punches, it squirts paint, and it punches some more. Here we go. Well, oh, he's ducked the paint, but not the fists. Avoided damaging his package, but it's not really an express delivery so far. Now, for the part of his route that he's dreading. Four big red spheres that don't know the meaning of the words do not bet. The big red balls. Oh, yeah, that works.
Oh, buddy.
Ball one. And he's in. Oh. Second class four.
That was rubbish.
Maybe he'll have a bit more luck on the final obstacle. It's the shapeshifter. Up the ladder, down the slide, and which window should we go through today? The square window. The triangle window. Or the round window. Yeah, that's right. Parole at the moment. Can't afford to hang around. Here we go. Oh, oh my goodness. Didn't even touch the sides. Look at that. If that was the aim, she'd have won. It wasn't. And now, Jason, onto the shapeshifter.
This is not very operatic to me.
Down he goes.
Oh, Jason.
Yeah. Rock Chick Jean completes the course in just under 5 minutes.
Rock and roll, baby!
Not really, no. But it's one tenor Jason that has something to sing about, finishing in 2 minutes 30.
The fat lady has sung. It's over.
Goodbye!
Next, it's Mum of Two, Kate from Wetherby. Her 3 and 6-year-old sons, Stanley and Max, made her apply for the show. I'm sure she'll do them proud. Okay, that's not a good start.
Don't underestimate this Yorkshire pudding!
My favourite type of pudding. Yorkshire. Okay! Ooh, a very elegant walk down the ramp. Oh, well, that got her to the bottom quicker, I suppose. Okay, she's up. Oh, she's lost a shoe, but the rest of her is still intact so far. Here we go. Oh, head smash.
Watch your head.
Yeah, too late. Oh, yeah, say that before it happens, not after. Okay, onto the sucker punch now. Oh, or not onto the sucker punch.
Hey, you haven't started yet.
That's what we call a welcome punch. Hi. And that's what we call just not very good. Right, silly mummy Kate finishes in just 2 minutes 23 and is the quickest lady so far. Your boys can officially be proud.
Stanley! For you!
Woo! Now, doing it for the dads is 39-year-old Tony, who has 8 children.
I'm the king of 8 and I'm here to state that everything here has to total 8.
You've got 8 children!
8 children. From 13 down to 10 days.
Can you name them for me?
I can. Aisha, Amira, Adnan, Adil, Aman, Amir, Aliyah, Alina.
He's not in my good books, you know. 8 children, all beginning with the letter A, and not one of them called Amanda.
Well, the octopopper is off. Tony hoping to prove that Dad has still got it. And he gets it, all right in the face. Now he's onto the sweeper, and now he's in. Yeah, that was falling with style. Jason's replacement, Tough Cookie Kim.
Can't show.
My motto in life is keep calm and carry on. That's so not going to work here, so I suggest keep calm, carry on, and run like crazy. It's Double Cross. Are you all ready? Yeah! 3, 2, 1!
The game is afoot. but nobody's moving their feet. Tash gives it a go. Oh, just a tester run, maybe. Emma. Ow. Ow. Oh, I think that was Kate. This thing is brutal. Hairdo Ron Ron. Lasted as long as his nickname. Remember, they can only use the green gangways to get into the middle. Second class Michael now, and oh! Ooh. Collecting the post right in the ankle. Right, it's Ron again. Come on. Oh! Yeah. Fastest qualifier, having no luck so far. This is Mr. Philip. Getting closer. Michael now is into the centre.
Finally.
Well, what's this? Thomas the Tank Top has joined Michael in the middle. Nitro Nathan now. Oh, very close. Quite good, Kev. Bolts for it. He's there as well. Things are getting a little crowded in the centre now. Remember, they're all just waiting for that red gangway to come round. It's the only way off. Oh, Michael! Got one foot under the red gangway, but then just sort of fell off. Kevin attempts the exit. Oh. That was close. Kevin almost made it across, but then there was a pirouette somersault flip of a fall.
I can do it! Yes, you can. There's no such thing as can.
Possibly. Thomas alone in the middle. Come on, people. Oh, Nathan heard me. Yes, he's on. He's on, he's off. He's on. He's still on. Mr. Phillip's back for more. Bit of a limbo. Oh. Mr. Phillip is trying everything. But where's Mrs. Eve? Finally, Thomas heads for the water. Getting off double cross is definitely difficult. Michael now, third time lucky. Hurdles the crosses and misses the middle completely. And in goes Nathan too. Ooh, Ron, into the middle. Surely he'll be able to do this. Don't get mad, get Emma, wants to join in, and she's there, just. Kevin again now, and he's there. Michael, too. This is good middle management or something. She came here for revenge, but the Terra-Go-Round had the last laugh. Farewell, don't get mad, get Emma. Quite good wasn't quite good enough for quite good Kev. And although he's leaving us, he can at least be with his wife once more, over on the spectator's bench. Farewell, Mr. Philip.
So there are only moments to go now before today's thrilling Wipeout Zone begins. I'm not entirely sure how long a moment is, but it just so happens I've brought my Victorian momentometer. So, yeah, 3 moments, 2 moments, 1 moment, Wipeout Zone! Yeah, momentometer's fast. It'll be coming up any time now, I imagine. Unless...
I'll tell you what I'm going to bring to this final. One word, bottle.
It's just so hard. There is nothing in the world that can pay for this.
Just unbelievable experience, and I'm never going to forget the experience for the rest of my life. I never would expect I could actually get into the final. And my family is going to be really proud of me, and especially my mum.
At the start, I didn't really expect much from him, but he's done a lot better than I thought.
He's a fit lad. But will he bottle it in the final? I think he will.
People thought that I'm going to be rubbish because of what I was wearing. And actually, I'm here. It's just amazing.
It nearly all went wrong, but I found my rhythm and I knew I'd come good in the end. And it's game on.
I think he's got really, really good potential because he doesn't give up and never stops.
I'm not far off half his age, so I feel I've got the better of him for this one.
To win here tonight would mean everything to me. You know, if you get the title of Total Wipeout Champion, no one's going to take that away from you.
If I win tonight, I will feel so good about myself. At the age of 17, I was diagnosed with cancer. From that experience, going through everything that I had to do, and then here we are, years later, I'm back fighting fit, now I'm ready to beat this.
This is for all the old boys, life begins at 40.
This is my time. I'm here ready to win this.
This is the biggest challenge in my life and I feel so excited.
This is going to be fantastic.
Three guys on the road to destiny, and there's no speed limit. Who's in the fast lane and who's on the hard shoulder? Waiting for the tow truck. This is the Wipeout Zone, and Michael is the first to brave it.
Can second-class Michael deliver yet another first-class performance?
Cometh the arm.
Hurdles the crosses and misses the middle completely, and in goes Nathan too. Ooh, wrong. Into the middle. Surely he'll be able to do this. Don't get mad, get Emma wants to join in, and she's there, just. Kevin again now, and he's there. Michael, too. This is good middle management or something.
Oh, it's a Wipeout pileup.
Oh, yeah. They're all now waiting for the optimum gap betwixt Red Gangway and Red Cross. That's the time to run for the finish. Kim piles on too. Kevin sees his chance, looking good. Quite good, Kev is the first to qualify for the next round.
Go on, the Irish.
Ooh. Out of nowhere, Nathan speeds across to the finish line too.
We have Nathan.
Nitro Nathan is through. Meanwhile, Thomas has reached the centre, and now Eve's chasing her husband. She's got the sweeper arm, but oh no, she's hanging on. Eve's position is rapidly becoming untenable, and she's been dropped. But her husband is still up, still in the middle.
Who? You?
Tense now, tense. Michael, second assault on the exit beam, jumps, and oh, not enough. Four places in the next round are still up for grabs. Who's got the legs to do it? Thomas making his move. Oh, superb, what a finish. Three down, three to go. Usually it's around here that it all gets very fast and frantic. Tash into the middle. Hairdo Ron, run. Can he make it? Yes, no. I feel for Ron, I really do. That was close. Oh. Kim sets off from the starting podium. Lovely skip and into the middle. But it's too crowded for Emma. She's off and leaps across the finish line. Well, actually, the next bit's the finish line there. Emma is through to the next round. So two places remain. Will they go to Michael, Kim, Philip, Eve, Ron, Tash, Alex, or Kate? Here comes Michael. Makes the middle again. And that's Mr. Philip. Ooh, takes one to the legs, but soldiers on to the middle, leaving his wife behind. Michael's got his eyes on the prize and just makes that jump. But Philip's hot on his heels. And like that, it's all over. Philip and Michael are through to the next round, joining Kevin, Emma, Thomas and Nathan, but not Philip's wife, Eve. And a huge upset for Ron, the fastest in the qualifier. He's out. And his hair's wet. Oh.
In years to come, that edition of Double Cross will claim its rightful place.